The Rotary Club of Glenferrie celebrated its 40th anniversary in October 2015 with a gala evening at the Wattle Park Chalet in Surrey Hills. Paul Harris Fellow recognitions were awarded to three charter members who are still active club members. Bruce Goff, Don Moore and Ian Dobson, seen here with the Mayor of Boroondara, Coral Ross. The club's major fundraising activity is the Boroondara Farmers Market that has raised over $1.2 million since 2003 to support local and international community service projects. The major beneficiary is the Boroondara Chances Scholarship Program, supporting disadvantaged students in the city of Boroondara. The club successfully established the Hawthorne Men's Shed in 2015 after 2 years of fundraising and community consultation and partnership with Uniting Aged Well. The club's major international project is the Sumba Eye Program in Indonesia, led by club member Dr. Mark Ellis. The program restores eyesight to sufferers of cataracts by providing free operations and by training local nurses and surgical staff. The Rotary Club of Glenferrie, celebrating 40 years of fellowship and community service in 2015.
These are starting to change the lives in a really positive sense of some of our residents. Thank you.
Hawthorne is a strong supporter of donations in kind, and this is a typical pallet of school desks and chairs in East Timor.
I'd like to congratulate the Rotary Club of Hawthorne on its continuing work to help and support those in our community who are socially isolated, particularly at Christmas time. The annual Christmas lunch is a unique and inclusive event, one of the largest in the city of Boroondara, that brings together people from across the entire city.
On September the 6th, I, as president of the Rotary Club of Kew, George Verginnis, received a phone call from my friend, past president Maragos, of the Rotary Club of Nausminy in Athens, asking me if we could help them with medical aid and consumables as they are unable to cope with the 3,000 refugees arriving every day by ships into the port of Piraeus, Athens. These poor homeless souls, these refugees, need a lot of help, and many need medical help, but Greece's hospitals are poor and overstrained. So Rotarian doctors are volunteering their time, but need supplies. So we at the Rotary Club of Kew organised a fundraising dinner dance, and Rotarians from District 9800 helped us raise approximately $16,000 to help the Rotarians of Athens to give humanitarian aid to the refugees.
I'm Justin Y. Brown. I'm the president of Yarra Bend Rotary for 2015-16. This Rotary year, we have instigated many changes to our club, and I'm pleased to say that members have embraced these with much gusto. On the communications front, we've upgraded our bulletin to a more sharper image, adopted Yammer as a club communication tool, adopted a more inclusive meeting style, and introduced new membership categories. Internationally, we continue our work in Nepal post-earthquake, and continue to grow our community centres both in Kopan and Kangal. Back home, we continue to assist with CAM care with garden maintenance and have contributed to building on a strong relationship with Kew High School by assisting with an educational sponsorship through an annual bursary. We continue to do garden development through the community and, of course, engagement with many youth Rotary youth programs. For the second year running, we've hosted the Boroondara Emergency Services Awards, a gala night where all services are recognised for service above self in our community. The club is also heavily involved in mentoring, where we train Rotarians from other clubs and are running two programs ourselves, including the mentoring of our Rotaract Club and the mentoring of a Neighbourhood Houses Committee of Management. Overall, we are a small, however, busy club involved in all avenues of Rotaries.
shine another night to shine. Akali, yeah, yeah. Uka kafisi ha mzuki. Ndoto pe moni. Amin zale katisi. Menoo.